फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द पार्ट टू ऑफ द कंप्लीट रिव्यू ऑफ LG 4012B6700. द पार्ट वन रिव्यू लिंक कुड बी फाउंड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन सेक्शन. सो कमिंग ऑन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर रिव्यू,
द टीवी इज वेरी सिंपल. सो आई सेलेक्टेड दिस टीवी इवन दो आई कंपेयर्ड सो मेनी अदर टेलीविजन्स बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग विद दिस पर्टिकुलर टेलीविजन. लाइक आई कंपेयर्ड फ्रॉम सोनी, आई कंपेयर्ड टू और थ्री मॉडल्स. From LG itself, I compared LA6910, 750D, like that. I was looking for the one which suits my budget and which is better for a family guy like me. What I could say is the TV is learning curve. Means my parents are also using YouTube, Facebook or etc. now, because this is a simple interface, there is nothing much confusing. So they can easily use, that's what I could say. So that was one of the aspects that I favored while choosing this particular TV. Then another one I think was regarding the headphone out, because I used to watch a lot of movies at night. So headphone out is a useful feature, even though now I am using I'm not using TV headphones, I'm using the home theater headphone out. But those who are not using a home theater headphone out, I think this is a useful feature, because if you want to watch anything at night, then headphone out is a useful feature regarding this particular television. Then the TV supports HEVC, which is a future aspect of coding, and in the next update I think HEVC will support, SmartShare also will support HEVC. So what happens is you could get very high quality videos in a very normal, means in a very low container size, like in an MKV or something. So that's a very good aspect I think for the future. Then the store is not okay, going inside the store, the LG store is not having very much much larger amount of applications at present. But I think normal or useful applications, this is a TV, not a mobile phone or something. So the amount of applications that you are going to use will be limited, because how many hours you will be watching the TV. So I think within that aspect, I would say like the normal useful applications, I think YouTube, most of the new apps, new videos and musics, everything I could get from that. Then SmartShare, you could come up with anything. It supports a USB drive or a media server, and currently I'm using, okay, the network is unstable, okay, leave that. So currently I'm using the SmartShare for watching all this, and it comes with the music aspect also for playing the music. You could go inside and play the music like that. Now there is an operation for repeat, for shuffling, for making a playlist, I mean for the playlist creation. Or you could from other devices, for example, if you are having a like I said, a media server here, then the media server will be shown here and all the contents will be shown over here. So that I think is a good aspect for this particular thing. And there's a search option, there's a search option which is a universal search. If you are searching for something here, for example, I'm searching the client, simply I'm searching the client in that aspect. What I could say is you could look at that, how many number of programs I am having open, and the TV is still having no lag at all. There is no lag, it's simply switches between the programs, and I think I am very much satisfied with this TV. I won't say anything like this TV is okay. One aspect that annoyed me also, I am a patient man, okay, but one aspect that annoyed me is I am using Videocon TV, so any details you take. While switching channels or while during other aspects, this TV is, you know, LG TVs are not having the black a great black level because of the use of IPS panel. The viewing angle is best, but at the cost of, at the expense of this black level at some point. So it's not visible at most of the time, but sometimes, for example, at the end credit of a movie or in a very dark scene, the TV switches automatically, means the TV reduces the backlight automatically. So this feature is called auto dimming. Sometimes, for example, if you are watching a very too dark movie, or if you are watching a at the end credits of a movie or at the initial credits of a movie where the screen almost 90%, 90 plus percent of the screen goes black, for example, now look at that. This screen, even that is okay. If the center portion also goes black, then at that point the TV will dim automatically. I don't know how to show you guys. I think I will try to show you guys. Okay, there's a slight dimming. You it's not visible or it's not evident in most of the times, but sometimes Now, when you're switching between some of the other programs, when you're switching between some other aspects, the thing will come live. That's the only thing that I think I got annoyed of this TV. Other than that, I would say like the pros. What I liked about this TV, it mainly consists of the viewing angle, which was very important for me. The viewing angle. Then another aspect is it's a very normal, I mean a decent TV for watching all the programs. I won't say anyone would say like this is a bad TV. This is not a bad TV. This is a very good TV, I would say. And other aspects, this is a feature-rich TV. Means you are having WebOS, there's a very good feature. And you are having other aspects like you are having a time machine for recording the programs. Okay, I forgot to mention time machine, right? Okay, regarding time machine, time machine supports only RF for DTV or ATV. So it supports recording an RF television like the normal composite in. So I think guys, that's all about this particular TV. So if you ask me what are the cons for this TV, one is that auto dimming aspect, which is a con for this TV. But apart from that, in my personal opinion, I can't find anything much that is wrong about this TV. And regarding the picture quality, if you ask me, it's having a decent picture quality as what you could see from here. And I won't say like it's lagging somewhere, but the true motion feature is sometimes annoying. Means for example, if you are in this program, you can't see any motion blur or anything because the true motion is now turned on. But in other case, it's not useful sometimes. It means in normal TV channel programs, if you are switching to some normal program, you will find it annoying. But that's simply you are having an option to turn it off. So I won't say it's an annoying feature or anything. But overall, I would give this TV a 4.5 out of 5, I think, because the TV, to its price point, I think it's worth. And it is worth mainly because of WebOS. Because WebOS is a clear game changer for LG, I think, this time. It's a very, very useful feature for switching between apps and everything. It's very easy. That's what makes it very good. So that's it for this video, and I think this is the final verdict of mine. If you are looking for TV, I would prefer to buy. I am not recommending anything at this point, but you could go for any WebOS TVs because WebOS is a very good TV. You could select any of the TVs WebOS. And from Panasonic, I think live screen is coming. So during my review, I reviewed AS650, but it lagged. The input lag was very high for that TV. So I used to play a lot of games in TV, so I didn't prefer to go for that particular TV because of that one aspect. And WebOS is a clear game changer between these two, I think. So I'm ending this video. It's a pretty long video, I know, but it's a final review, so I thought I should cover some of the aspects. And all the things that I've said, I've clearly explained in my other videos. So you could check out the other videos for more info regarding this particular TV model or LG's calibration settings, the TV calibration settings that is almost similar to all the TVs, and some of the main features that if you would like to try out, some of the main features that you could check in my channel. And my upcoming videos will be regarding the other aspects, like some of the applications I'm going to try and to let you see how those are performing, and some of the common aspects like the black level. Some of the guys asked me about the black level, the auto dimming, how it is working. I would like to show you guys how it is actually working in a separate video or something. So I think that's it for today. Hope this helps someone looking for to buy a TV or looking for a new TV or some features of a TV, anything. Because I got a lot of info from YouTube during unboxing or any other reviews or tutorials or something. So I thought of contributing back to YouTube community using what I am having. Okay, so this is a new TV, and I don't think not much information is available online or on YouTube. So I thought I would give you guys a sneak look at this. So thanks for watching the video, and hope this helps someone. Cheers, guys. Thank you.